Hello guys, welcome to our channel. So today, as you all know from the timetable, we are covering political science chapter 1, what is democracy and why democracy. This is used to be one of the interesting chapter for those who love social science, but also this is the first chapter because the first chapter that is in your book has not been included in your course. So it will be the first chapter that we'll continue. So today we're going to cover the introduction part of this chapter. What is democracy? What is the simple definition for a common person it belongs to? And we'll take some examples of countries like Pakistan, Myanmar, and Saudi Arabia. Introduction is democracy. As we all know, democracy is people's rule. People's rule basically means that the people has the enormous powers to rule the country by themselves in the way they want. They choose the elected representatives from whom they want to be governed from. People have saying in decision makings. Also, people can regulate or make the pressure on the government to check whether the government is working correctly or not. Now, this isn't given. Second point is that democratic countries and non-democratic countries. Democratic countries are those which follow the democracy exactly. How? That democracy is not just giving elections or not just selecting the representatives, but also democracy means people have the enormous powers in the country to make the decision and also to rule the country in whatever way they want. Non-democratic countries are one which do not been following the democracy, and also there is only a one-man rule, or you could say monarchy, and the lifespan ruling will be there. It means that the president or prime minister, whoever so is ruling that in that country, could rule at whatever time rate of his or him want. We will be coming up across some stories and conversation through. So there is a case studies, so many case studies given in a book, so we're going to cover them. Let us see what are the case studies. First, democracy means it is a form of government. That form of government matlab ek government ka tarika hai. Of the people, by the people, and for the people. For the people matlab logo ke liye, by the people matlab logo ke dwara, or of the people matlab logo se hai. So the democracy is a form of government of the people, for the people, and by the people. Now, this basic definition has been given by the United Kingdom's president, first black president, that is Mr. Abraham Lincoln. He gives the exact definition which we all know today. If we could ask it to the child in the smaller classes even, then the standard definition would be democracies of the people, for the people, and by the people. This definition we learn in our daily lives about democracy. Let's learn the true meaning of it and how the countries follow democracy in way they are. So here we have three case studies, and also we are going to see to the basic definition. First is child before and after Pinochet rule. Dictatorship rule in child for 17 years. Dictatorship means we should say it in Hindi, Tanashah. That means the person who is ruling the country but not listening to anyone. He is ruling the country in whatever way it's want, and no one is capable to even say him that he is not doing right. So that is the monarchy, one man rule or one person rule, the monarchy, and the leader in the monarchy is called the dictator, and it established dictatorship in the country. Poland after the fall of communist rule. Now, the Poland updates a decommunization legislation to include sovereign propaganda. Now, what's happened in Poland is that first the community government used to rule there, but after the fall of communist government, they formed a new government of Russia government. And that's, we all know that Russia has a monarchy rule, it's a one-man rule, and it does not follow democracy. Ghana, in the early period of government, disease caused high losses among the Europeans engaged in slave trade, but profits realized from the trade continued to attract them. The growth anti-slavery sentiment. Now this means, this is talking about a disease that has been spread at that time into the whole country. And so many people, like just now, we are even suffering from a virus for the pandemic that we are learning online today. This is the reason why we are attracted towards this online session or online things, because we cannot go out and we need to fight this. So the same thing has happened here. Disease is called high losses in Europe and engage so many slave trades. They continue to attract them. Now, disease has spreaded, but since people were so many engaged in the trade, they do not have been seeing to the, like in our country, people nowadays are not paying attention to what the government is making the rules for them. Everyone is violating the rule. Some of them were really following, but some of them are paying a careless attention to their countries and government's sayings. So the previous basic definition is too simple, because of most governments have election, but not all democratic. Now, as I told you, democracy does not lie before the votes, does not lie before the people's choice to representatives or the person whom they want to be governed from. But democracy, one of the example of China has elections after even the interval of 5 years, but that election does not carry any meaning to the people, because it's just a way to make that the country is democratic, but the people who were ruled by the same leader at that time. So election carries no meaning in that countries. Now, non-democratic countries, we are taking the case of Myanmar and Saudi Arabia. Now, what happens in Myanmar is the controller of army becomes the ruler, and clearly they have people no say in decision. Now, democracy provides a reason and provides a clear way that people have sayings in decision making. Rather, it can be leveled at their level, at country level. People could have saying in that. But in Myanmar, it was not so. The country was democratic. The people elect the representatives, but they do not have the people say. So it cannot really establish democracy in that state. The kings of Nepal and Saudi Arabia rule not because people have chosen them to do, but they happen to born in a royal palace. Now, what does this mean, that king of Nepal and Saudi Arabia here, they only get chosen by the people, and just for the take the pleasure of the, where the, you can say, we when the elective members have been appointed, they're given special households and facilities to live their life. So Nepal and Saudi Arabia kings follows the main part to live a luxurious life rather than ruling the country, rather than paying attention to the work that they have been elected for. Now major decisions taken. In this case, we'll be talking about Pakistan. How Parvez Musharraf, you might have not been gone through this term and name, but this is in a very dramatic way how this man from a general executive declared himself to be the president of the country. October 1919, General Parvez Musharraf led a military troop. Now what had happened, he was the head in military. So he inspired the military and people to join the community which he was forming. And finally in October 1919, he followed that company. Overthrew democratic elected government. Now the government has been elected in Pakistan that time. And as the moment the decision made, General Parvez Musharraf declared himself as the chief executive of the country in 2000. Without asking anyone, he declared himself to be the chief executive. So this is the way this makes the Pakistan non-democratic country. Now, what all changes he made after he was being assigned as a president? First was, he changed his designation of president. Now, what does this means, that designation of president means ki uske dekhne ka nazariya ab uske badal gaya. Now he was not a military troop head, but he was the head of the whole country and he was to look out the whole country. So the referendum in 2002, he led a referendum, granted him a 5-year extension. Now what he does is, he himself granted him a 5 years extension. We know that in democracy, people used to choose the government, people used to elect the government after the interval of every 5 years. Like we have census after every 11 years. Like we have elections every 5 years. So the Pakistan has the elections, and so they do not carry any meaning to the people. And Parvez Musharraf himself declared that he would rule the country 5 years more and give himself an extension of 5 years. Under his rule, democracy was all full of fraud and malpractices. Now, this means that he did not follow any rule which makes the democracy possible in Pakistan. So it is given the term fraud, because fraud means something that has been guaranteed but not given to you on what the basis the deal has been done. Fraud means agar aaj aapne kisi ko kuch promise kiya aur fir aap usko nahi karte and you cheated that person. So it would be a fraud for that. And malpractices means now people do not care that what should the president would say. They started practicing some rituals, some started practicing other activities on their own self without taking the permission from the government. On August 22, he issued the legal framework order that amends the constitution of Pakistan. Now what he did is, in 2002, he amends the constitution of Pakistan and named him as a legal framework order. Rather, it was named as legal framework order, but it was not a real way. It's just an illegal, because the president could not amend the constitution on its own decision. It needs to be taken by all the elected representatives and dignitaries of the country. This order stated the president can dismiss and national provincial assemblies. Now this amendment in constitution of Pakistan really led a great backup for the Parvez Musharraf, and people decided that they do not want this type of leader in their country. And finally, people started the marches to dismiss the president, and they wanted a new president for the country. Although the elections took place, but the final power were hands of Parvez Musharraf. This shows that the country was not actually democratic. Now what happens? Now elections would happen in the country, votes were even given, people participated at the maximum level. But still, after the election, the ruler which has to become did not been reporting that time, and Parvez Musharraf has been assigned as a president after that also. So this makes the country undemocratic. Election does not mean that the country is democratic, but democracy should be followed evenly. So the first feature we get is, in India, in democracy, the final decision-making power must rest within those by the elected people. This is the form of government that which the people can make the laws. So this is all for today, and we'll have the mentee quiz even for this chapter. This is just a simple chapter. I'll just give you an overview. And first we had learned about the introduction of the democracy. That is, the democracy is for the people, of the people, and by the people. Democracy's simple definition is people's rule, means it is all the parameters favors the people to work there for the country. We are taking 3 case studies of Poland, Myanmar, and Saudi Arabia. Also, we had made a point, we had pointed the last thing, that has been the election does not make any sense in democracy till they are not followed in a symmetrical way. We had studied about the case study of Parvez Musharraf in Pakistan, how he led the troops and how he led to the himself the president of the country without regarding the needs and deeds of the people. Then we understand that what makes the Pakistan undemocratic, because Pakistan and China has the same story. They do not even have a democratic country because they used to have elections, but they do not really follow them. So we had learned this. And the first feature that we get is, in democracy, the final decision-making power must rest by the elective representatives. So this is all for today. And we'll be beginning with our half part of the chapter in the next class. Till the time, if you want to make notes, then you can go for it. And also, you have to answer these questions in chats. First question is, in which year did General Parvez Musharraf declare himself as the president of the country? Kindly write your answer in the chat as fast as you can. In which year did General Pervez Musharraf declared himself as the Pak president of country? Okay, so your next question is, I will tell you the answer after you will be answering in the chat box. Was the rule in Pakistan during Pervez Musharraf was democratic? Now you have to tell that before the General Pervez Musharraf inclined himself as the president of Pakistan, before that the country was democratic or it was still undemocratic. What form of government is followed in India? This question is something that is related to our country and it is easier to answer because we know much more better than that of our other countries. India, as I told you, is our biggest state. Its population is very large and also it has the lengthiest constitution in the world. So this makes the India democratic. So you have to write the answer. What form of government is followed by India? What do you think is more better? You have to give your own choice. Now this is a choice question. If you like non-democratic, then you have to give reasons for that. At least you should have two reasons. True, strong reason which could prove that why did you prefer non-democratic or democratic country. So this is the reason you have to write your answers. So these are the four questions that you need to answer in the chat box. I'll be waiting for the answers and the fast and the correct answer will be shown on the screen in the next session. Till the time, thank you.
Oh, it's not enough.